Hello. Happy Wednesday. This is Laura. All right, let's check out again the IRS.gov website. Now, I am not a tax advisor. It's very important that I say that for all the legal reasons. I am a computer technician who has lots of different technology, internet, and other types of experience where I can make these videos to help you learn how to navigate something on the internet or learn how to research something. And in this case, it is different things that relate to the IRS upcoming tax season. Yay! All right, so let's go back in here. And what I want to look for now, this is on the front page first. We'll check that out. They have your online account you can create, child tax credit update portal. You can take a look at that. And then, where's my refund? Get your tax records. Get my payment. Pay directly from your bank account. When you owe, identify protection, IP PIN, identity protection, IRS.gov mobile app, there you go, and your online account back there again. So that is the home page along with these areas here. There are several. Very clean, very nice, all the way down the page. You can look at any of these sections that will give you lots of valuable information. It's a great site for you to be able to use to find information that you need to help answer your questions. If you don't know how to research your information, it's best that you do talk to a tax advisor. And they will be able to guide you also in the right direction, at least a lot better than me. I don't know your situation at all, and I don't ask personal questions to relate to your situation. Your situation is unique to you, so you have to ask an accountant or tax advisor for direction in order to keep IRS off your back and just take care of business the right way. Okay, so what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to do a search for Gig. The IRS has accepted this term, Gig. We have 86 matches. Wow. Look at that. They even have a publication on it. Gig Economy, Tax Center. Taxpayers must report gig economy earnings when filing taxes. Okay, all this cool stuff. Everything that has to do with gigs. Gigs, as in Grubhub and DoorDash and Uber and Airbnb and all those cool gigs, right? If you're making money through an app, it's a gig, probably. And they also have a topic. If you don't call it a gig, you can call it other income. You know, since there are so many different ways to make income now, perhaps you make income from Amazon store or print on demand. I mean, stores, there's all kinds of different ways. So these are all the different sections that relate to gig. I'm going to go back one, and then I'm going to go back to the other one, number one. And we're going to go back up to the top. And we're going to take a quick look at where it starts. Let's see what we find. Oh. One page. Well, okay. So they do say, though, right here, if you earn a paycheck as a gig economy employee, your employer usually withholds tax from your pay to help cover the taxes you owe. If you're a gig economy worker who's not considered an employee, two ways you can help cover your taxes are submit a W-4, where you fill out and submit a new W-4 for other jobs where you work as an employee. Make quarterly estimated tax payments. It's very important, I've heard, that they really enforce quarterly payments. And we will take another look at that in a moment. Some of the tax forms that you will receive from a person you work for or who pays you, and you give them your EIN or Social Security number, will be these forms here: Form 1099 Miscellaneous, Form 1099-K. Those two. The W-2 is a form that only an employee receives. W-2, usually on a W-2, as far as I know, taxes are taken out of it. 1099s, they are not. So, again, you must speak to a tax advisor that relates to your specific, unique situation that's only in your life. Everybody has their own unique tax situation. No matter how much you might think it's not that way, it really is. So, all right. So, Gig Economy Tax Center. And let's, I want to look at this one. Ah, here we go. So, they have some videos here talking about the gig economy. More here. What is the gig economy? Also called sharing economy or access economy. It's actually where people earn income providing on-demand work, services, or goods. Often it's through a digital platform like an app or website. All right, that may include a site like Fiverr. It could include, I suppose, Etsy. It could, I mean, any of those sites like that are providing a platform where you make money by using their platform. And they don't pay your taxes. You have to be responsible for your own taxes. You're virtually self-employed. So you have like part-time, temporary, or side work. They call it any one of those things. They're not reported on an information return form. Form 1099-K, 1099 miscellaneous, W-2, or other income statement. So the gig economy, like let's say you have an Etsy shop. So far, they were not supposed, they did not have to report earnings. Now I've heard that the 1099-K is starting to be enforced. And, you know, whatever it is, they're gonna try to enforce it. So, and rules and laws can change also every year. And we've had some pretty big congressional bills go through Congress, you know, three of them in the past 2 years. So you definitely want to talk to a tax advisor and see if a little IRS thing is in any one of those, because there will be stuff in there. Sometimes good stuff, sometimes not so good stuff. So make sure you check. Okay, gig workers manage taxes. Okay, now the best thing about this website is it will be up to date on rules and laws and stuff. So here are some examples of gig work that they're talking about. It's funny, ride sharing services. People have been doing that for decades. Yeah. Okay. So there you go. They're going to have a webinar on it. So if you think you fall in this category, make sure you study this whole entire section. Make sure you listen to everything in here. Make sure you click on these links, and like this one, it's going to go to another section, right? And then you're going to go through all of that, and it's going to tell you that down here all about different records. It's going to tell you about different, I mean, these are several pages. They could be a couple hundred pages long. You don't know. So if it, this one would, I think, relate to Airbnb, starting a business and keeping records is information for you if you did just start a business. Even if you start one in 2022, business expenses, that one will explain what that means. And then travel, gift, and car expenses, which I think are a lot less than they used to be before 2020, but I don't know for sure. And then it talks about quarterly paying instant quarterly taxes to be paid, April 15th, June 15th, September 15th. The January 15 one, usually, I think this year can wait till March, I don't know. But again, check with your tax advisor. Oops, get ready to file, and this will explain all kinds of things to help you, be ready, go through all of this, and figure out what you need to give to your tax advisor. That's always helpful, and the more informed you are, the more money you'll get back. That way you know what's going on. There you go. And then file your tax return. IRS free file is another section. I have it'll let you know if you are allowed to file for free, because you have to qualify to file for free. And then it will the system if the system says yes, you can, then it will go to another page and show you where you can file for free. Don't fall for scams. Make sure that you follow all the rules. And this is the best place to go so that you don't fall for any scams. Make sure you go to IRS.gov and do your research in this website to help you get the most money you can back from the government or not have to pay as much as. As little as possible, for instance, to pay as little as legally possible. Don't do anything illegal. Okay, there we go. So that is the video for today, and I will get this uploaded. Please have a safe week and take care of yourself, take care of people around you. Make sure that you're in great shape so that other people who care about you can be with you longer. And please click on the subscribe button and share my videos if you would like to be supportive. And please click the like button also if you receive some helpful tips here or to help support the channel as well. In order to help other people be able to find it and receive good tips. And I will work on more videos. So have a good day. Thank you. Bye-bye. Laura out.